And then the rest of you that are in the in your chairs, take out your green insert, if you will. It's a green insert. The names, so hopefully we didn't forget any names on here. Hopefully all the names are spelled correctly too. If they're not, it's not my fault. I use Microsoft Word, and I had error check on there, but that doesn't always do things for names. Okay, anyway. I want to welcome all of you in the Lord's name to the Church of Creston. And all of us have come into this church through a confession of faith. Every one of us became members of this church by confessing our faith in the Triune God. And so we want you as well to confess the faith. And so I'm going to ask you four questions. First question is this. Do you believe in the Triune God, the Trinity, the Father who created you and still now sustains you, the Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who died and rose again for you, and the Holy Spirit, who has brought you to the saving faith? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you accept and confess that the teachings of this church, as you have learned to know them, are faithful and true to the Word of God? If so, answer, I do. And thirdly, as a member of this church, do you intend to continue in the confession of this church, attend worship faithfully, and with the guidance and strength of the Holy Spirit, lead a God-pleasing life? If so, answer, I do so intend with the help of God.
I do so intend with the help of God.
And finally, will you support the church? Will you support the work our gracious Lord has given this congregation with your prayers, your time, your financial resources, and your talents? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Upon this your promise, I, in the name of the congregation, welcome you into our fellowship, into our family. We pray that God would always use all of us, each of us, in our own different ways, because we all have different talents, different personalities. We all have different experiences in life. And that God would use each one of us as members of His body, so that we can all work together as one body in order to have an influence in our community, in our world. That's my prayer. Is that God could use us as a church, because that's why we're here, to be used by God. That's our only purpose. That's our purpose for existence as a church, is to be used by God for His glory, for His honor, but that many people could come to know the Lord Jesus. So let me pray that right now upon this church. Father, I thank you for these people who have come to be a part of our family. And Lord, we just pray that you would use each one of us, because we're all special and we're all individuals. Father, use us as we are. Yes, empty vessels in many ways, but yet filled with your Spirit continually. Use us. Use the abilities that you have given us for your honor, for your glory. Bless these people now, Lord, and use them as only you can. In the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. God bless you. We now go back to your seats. Let's welcome them.